Wow, you're such a great dancer. This is like my first time coming to the dance tonight. Would you like to dance? Do you see the color of my bracelet? I don't think so.
Never coming back to this dance again.
We've all been there in some capacity. I'm not saying every person who can dance a little bit better than everybody else is that extreme, but we've all faced some type of social dance rejection. So why should mature dancers dance with inexperienced dancers? Stick around, we're going to get into it. Lindy Hop as a dance form is not very big. I mean, when you really think about it, there's like billions of people on the planet and maybe 100,000 of us Lindy Hoppers. So any person who has a modicum of Lindy Hop skill is really a hot commodity. In my experience after visiting communities all over the world, there are two major benefits in having a mature dancer dance with an inexperienced dancer. The first thing that I would say is it's an investment in the future swing dance community. Lindy Hop typically has a 5-year shelf life. People go through life. You get through college, you get married, you have kids, and eventually Lindy Hop doesn't become a priority for the average person. Since everyone's life is different and no one knows who's going to be around to keep your Lindy Hop community healthy, it's smart to continue to reach out. The very first time that I went to a swing dance event, I had a really good dancer ask me to dance, and I was blown away by the way it felt. And I actually felt the essence of call and response. That transfer of energy was like a transfer of belief into what I could eventually become as a dancer. Their humility in reaching out created a desire for me to want to go through my own journey to get better. The mature dancer indirectly set a precedent for me to imitate, duplicating a behavior that would directly impact the growth of the Lindy Hop community. Talk about inception! If there's a large social gap between the mature dancers and the inexperienced dancers, at some point the inexperienced dancers won't have fun, they won't invite their friends, or they won't come back. In essence, you want to be thinking about how to replace yourself so that in the next 5 years, your community can continue to grow with or without you. The second benefit that I see in having mature dancers dance with inexperienced dancers is that inexperienced dancers will grow faster. It's almost impossible for a beginner dancer to mature if they're dancing with people on their level all the time. It's like the blind leading the blind. Haven't you heard that statement before, that a confused mind does nothing? That's generally what will happen when an inexperienced dancer doesn't get an opportunity to dance with better dancers to mature. They'll just get frustrated and quit. Or they'll take like 20 years to be able to do a swing out. If you're a follower, the best thing that you can do is dance with a leader who's a little bit better than you. The big catch is if they're really good, you're never gonna know if you're doing anything wrong. You're gonna have to have the guts to ask, what can I do to get better in this process? And in doing that, you're gonna be able to aggregate practical wisdom to assist you in your social dancing. Now, if you're a leader, you're gonna have to dance with followers who are better than you.
No, can't dance with her. She's like the international, no.
I know the feeling, it's intimidating, but it's gonna be the only way you're gonna be able to discover if you're doing something right or wrong. Now, your partner's not gonna know your intentions, but you can always ask if you're causing pain or if you have an idea that you're working on, if you're able to communicate that idea with clarity. Now, I am telling you this from my own experience. If you begin to apply these concepts in your swing dance community, it will make a dramatic impact. If you like what you've heard today, make sure you subscribe to the channel to get more about swing dancing, swing music, and swing history. If you want to learn how to fix yourself throughout your social dance journey, take my Fundamentals and Beyond course. It's going to really help you. If I don't get a chance to see you guys on the dance floor, hopefully I get a chance to see you in one of my classes online. Take care.